Hello and welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube if you're watching this video later on over there for Selesnya Titans is our first deck. This is made by the viewer in chat here, Borderland Ranger, made this deck. And so I have linked in the description, not just like the deck list on my Stream Decker, I have the deck list to their Aether Hub, which has a lot of writing about the deck. So if you want to learn more about it, all the card choices, all the stuff in the sideboard, what they're all for and everything like that, check that out. If you're here in chat, of course, you can hit exclamation point deck list to be able to find that, of course. So let's see what we have going on here. So we're playing a mid-range deck that we have it called Titans based on our two 6/6 creatures that are problematic for people to deal with Nullhide Ferox and God Eternal Oketra. It's technically a 3/6, but Oketra attacks for 6 because of the double strike. So these are just huge undercosted threats that are just, you know, have a lot of power and toughness. So we're trying to get those things out early with Llanowar, Paradise Druid. We have, for some card advantage, come on, Hawkeye. Besides those, we have our two Vivians. Here with the three mana Vivian and our five mana Vivian. We all know how good five mana Vivian is and has been, but three mana Vivian seems like it's starting to pick up a lot of play in the format also, because it allows you to play the instant speed game, which is just so valuable. And it can provide some card advantage also with the -2 ability. But yeah, giving any of your creatures flash is really nice. You can have a card like Tulsimer come in at flash instant speed and do some fighting, kind of messes up combat and everything. So three Tulsimer seems like a lot, but we'll see how powerful this card ends up being. We got four Knight of Autumns in here because the Simic Nexus is kind of a tough matchup for this deck. And Knight of Autumn just kind of does a lot in the format. There's a lot of red decks, even good against Esper with their Ascantas, or just being a 3-mana 4/3 body is just a pretty nice deal also. So yeah, this is definitely a really good metagame for Knight of Autumn. So like how we got four of those in there. We got four of the new removal spell from War of the Spark, Prism Realm. This is one that I haven't really played with at all. it does have the Scribe 1 attached to it, which is really nice. I've been, you know, I like Ixalan's Binding quite a bit, and Ixalan's Binding can get, you know, something like Wilderness Reclamation, for example, where Prison Realm can't. Prison Realm can only exile creatures and planeswalkers. But Prism Realm not only has the Scry 1 attached, but it also only costs 3 mana, which is a big deal whenever you're playing like Nullhide Ferox. So even if you have a Ferox in play, it only costs 5 mana to still play, which is a lot. But 6 is, like, Ixalan's Binding with 6 is, like, kind of not really doable. We got some interesting sideboard choices here. We got Remorseful Cleric as, like, a card that can come in against Nexus or Esper just to be a cheap threat that's only a 2/1 flyer, but can take out the graveyards if they have a bunch of Chemisters Insight in them, or if they're about to flip Ascanta, anything like that. Of course, great against Izzet Phoenix as well. Wander, obviously very good against red, plus some bigger creatures. They got Rekindling Phoenix, Seraph of the Scales, anything like that. Exile those creatures, which is really nice. Single Combat is a card that I'm kind of interested to play. I don't really view Single Combat as a standard playable card, but you know, maybe I'm wrong about that. So, oh, thanks, Jelly Tug. I'll do that. So, yeah, maybe we'll see how it goes. So basically what this card is in here to do is for the decks that are going wide, like Selesnya Tokens or Azorius Aggro that goes really wide. You're just for 5 mana, you're making them sacrifice all their things except for just one. Like, you know, they get to keep one creature, but gets rid of the rest. And of course, our one creature is probably going to be a lot better than their one creature. I've traditionally used like Settle the Wreckage there in that slot. But all right, so that's our deck. Let's go ahead and give it a try here with Selesnya Titans. We're gonna go over to our traditional constructed queue for today. I like dealing with the donation decks, and we have a couple other brews that we're trying out here with Bant Legends and Mono White Angels. I'll probably be playing this queue with those as well today. Hey, K. Mueller, thank you very much for that sub right there. Welcome to the channel. Okay. Update the stream title. I forgot to do that before. 24 months for K. Mueller? Wow. 2 years. Thank you so much. That deserves a lot of hype votes. All right, first sub of the day. Hey, CL. All right, I'm getting Deckmaster up also. It's a pretty nice looking hand that we got here. Got a good amount of our earlier creatures. Playing against Vendilion Click? I'm pretty sure Vendilion Click's not legal in this format. Should probably call a judge. We're already in kind of a crossroads here. It's kind of tough to do. Do you think I'll have a Vanifar Neoform deck soon? Potentially. That's one, yeah, I still need to make one of those. Yeah, I'll probably make one of those kind of soon. Okay. So, like, Oketra is, like, what I want to do here, but I guess this looks like Esper Control. And then if it's just Kaya's Wrath, I'm going to feel pretty bad. Am I going to feel that bad? Maybe not. We'll still have Nullhide Ferox as like a really good follow-up.
Before
action. That was a really quick minus.
This was overwhelming.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I updated Bant Legends on Stream Decker already. Because I think I uploaded it on Saturday. So it should be up. All up to date there. Hey, Illman. Howdy. No, if Oketra gets countered, it just goes to the graveyard. Yeah, Lala, lots of information down in the info panel about that. Honestly, I would not have been surprised if my opponent took Nullhide Ferox there, just to put it on the battlefield, and then Kaya's Wrath everything away. Hey, what's up, E-Weaver? Welcome back for the 20th month. Second sub of the day. We'd like to find our planeswalkers. That's really what, you know, what we want for getting card advantage. That's unfortunate.
Putrid, but effective.
Ugin's been good. Expensive, of course, but good. That was going to be, if our opponent had nothing, that was going to be a good turn for us there with Tulsimer being able to enter, and both Tulsimer and the wolf that it makes are legendary, so that's two legendary creatures. So the mobilized district would have cost two less to activate. And so we would have been able to kill their 2/2 and activate the mobilized district to kill the Liliana. Would have been a really nice turn, but... We'll have the Remorseful Cleric, the Vivian, and I guess that's all we got here. I guess I maybe play these Harpooners. Yeah, I guess I should bring in these Harpooners also. For just a cheaper threat that deals damage, and if they have like Thief of Sanity, you can take those out. Cause I don't like Prison Realm at all in this matchup. Just getting rid of a planeswalker for a little bit whenever it's easily answered with Mortify or Teferi. I wanna just be very threat heavy, not answer heavy. And then Oketra and Tulsimer. Both of these being 5-mana legends that are, you know, easily countered, or in Oketra's case, we see you can just mortify it. Trades down on mana basically all the time. I would never take out Branchwalker here. I like Branchwalker a whole lot. I think we want to get rid of one of these. All right, we'll take out Branchwalker. Maybe I should have just not brought in one of the Harpooners for the Branchwalker. Because we have one of our very, very best cards here in Vivian. We have the mana creatures to start with. But it's kind of tough keeping one land. So we're looking at like playing Llanowar Elf on turn one. On turn two, we're playing Paradise Druid without playing land. And then we hope that we get to untap and have 3 mana for one of these things. Hand's like basically perfect if we had one more land. It's kind of hard mulliganing and getting a not so good hand. Because with one land, this hand is perfect. Certainly a risk keeping it. That's So much of Magic is just, you know, trying to determine which risk to do.
How this thing goes is up to you, pal. Tear it down! Tear it all down!
So good news, we hit that land. Kind of bad news, we just put two Vivians on the bottom of the library. Hey, Trox says, I've been playing with your Simic midrange deck a bunch and wondering if you could talk about sideboarding with that deck. I get what to add, but what to remove versus controller Nexus isn't clear to me. Remove the Hydras, and I feel like I missed the punch. Remove the ramp, and I feel like playing into their long game. Also understand you're playing donation decks right now, so I can wait on that discussion. So I played the Paradise Druid during my turn there, even though we have Flash, because they were tapped out, and in case... You know, like I definitely didn't want that countered. It has hexproof, so we didn't really have to worry too much about it.
Wait, you think nature is kind?
But to answer your question, yes, I'd remove Hydras against control and Nexus. Maybe not against Nexus, definitely against control. The size that it has isn't really that important with how easy they can kill, just cast down, mortify, all that kind of stuff. I don't really want... I don't really want 5-mana creatures that give no card advantage against control.
You can still walk away.
It's a good Jade Light Ranger. This is going about as good as it can for us so far. Yes, we could have a creature resolve, but then if they have a Kaya's Wrath, it's like, what's the point of having a creature resolve there? We've got to play around Enter the God Eternals. That's a good point.
The mysteries of life are endless.
So basically getting the null hide in while we know it will be able to get a hit in. Put them down to 6. If they have Kaya's Wrath, which they'll need, we still have Tulsimer, which puts 6 power with them being at 6. All right, I'm going to get that Branchwalker back in for a Harpooner. Yeah, Vigilance Paradise Druid is a really nice combo. Yeah, Paradise Druid with Nissa. Keep it having hexproof. And just mana creatures in general, being able to attack and then also being able to sit back on defense is a really nice combination. This is my first time playing this, Carvalho. This is a donation deck. Definitely liked these Night of Autumns. Alright, now we have like 6 power in play. We can kind of sit back now. It's unfortunate that I don't have like something good to punish them if they're just going to be like Chemister's Insighting this turn. Kind of thing. Okay, well, in that case, let's Jade Light Ranger.
Into battle and make new comrades.
Not beating that card.
Effective.
With a 2/1. Yep, flooded out.
I can no longer stand. Hold that thought.
Planeswalkers are really good. Planeswalkers are really good. Game 1, they had planeswalkers, we lost. Game 2, we had a planeswalker, we won. Game 3, they had planeswalkers, we lost. All right, 0-1. I liked it whenever we had the Vivian more, and then having all those lands. Yeah, that's the thing. If you get your Vivians in play against Esper, you're going to be doing really good. If you don't have Vivians against Esper, you're going to be really struggling. No, I don't think they'll ever make a standard format again without Planeswalkers. I could see there maybe being a set without any Planeswalkers. But I can't imagine they would go that long without Planeswalkers. It's like asking if they would have a standard format without artifacts or enchantments or... you know, stuff like that. Like, that's not gonna happen. Yeah, I was always really high on Chandra. Chandra's just a really solid planeswalker. That the set has just a lot of them, and so a bunch of them were overlooked in the preview season. I'm in a good mood to go. Just had a long weekend. I'm just pretty worn out. I think I want to go Nullhide over Champion of the Wilds. I think Champion of the Wilds is a better card against an Absorb deck than a Nullhide is. Ketra. Or that's Kefnet. Gosh.
Hey,
Kefnet.
No,
so
restoration. I always
we get to resolve our Vivian, which is quite nice. And now we get the nice thing of being able to play double Vivian here.
I've seen that would break someone like you.
And even if one is countered, the other should resolve.
Let's tear this place apart. For the fallen.
I don't think I just attack into this mobilized district, but then it lets them cast up instant speed. Mobilized district is just really strong here. You know, it's a 3-3. If I just attack with my 2-1, they could just spend their 4 mana, activate, and kill my creature. And that's pretty rough. So I let them do their scry first, so they don't have the information that their prison realm is not going to last very long.
The wilds are my shield. There is wonder in a blade of grass.
Hmm. Really? Really? Root snare? 4 damage when you're at 22 and you need a root snare? That's a complete waste of a card. Gotta save
Not
up
again.
20.
Let me show you what was lost.
I probably shouldn't be shocking there, because we were only at 20. Huh. Imagine if they still had that root snare. Yep, they're dead now. I wasted that root snare. Alright, so they're a Bant. Definitely a Bant flash deck. Kefnet being the only threat that we see, but every single card they played was an instant speed card. And looks like they're pretty control-y with Revitalize, Root Snare, and Time Wipe. Certainly getting this Vivian in play.
Yeah. Definitely getting this thing.
There's... So, definitely want this Vivian. I don't think there's anything else that I want. Replacing it with the Tulsimer. Unlikely they're going to have, like, smaller creatures. The life gain doesn't seem like it matters. So it's, like, 2/3/3s. Which isn't bad. But they're legendary. would never take out Llanowar Elf in a mid-range matchup like this. Like, anytime you play mid-range decks, like, Llanowar Elf is just your, it's like your best card. Never take that card out. The only time to take out Llanowar Elf is against, like, hard control, where they have, like, tons of sweepers, like, maybe if you want it out there, or, like, against, like, a bunch of chain whirlers. You know, basically things that can sweep up Llanowar Elf without you getting much value for your Llanowar Elf. Hey, what's up, Rex? You went camping this weekend? Okay. Yeah, the sub battle was a ton of fun. David, my friend David Jones was over. We had just had lots of fun with it. I got it up on YouTube yesterday. And so, you know, you can see the replays there. Again, I'm not too concerned about the two life. And I think I want white mana in play, which is why I just played the Temple Garden there. They're trying to target the Paradise Druid. That doesn't work.
I didn't go through hell to lose to you.
Good job, Vivian. Yeah, that's a good part. Yeah, good point, Zoe. Thank you so much. Another card to board out against Esper Control and Nexus. I was talking about the Simic mid-range deck is Wildgrowth Walker. Yeah, that you board that card out against both of those decks. Yep, that's a good one there. Ooh, love it. On the play, turn two Vivian. Hey, what's up, Popeye? Good afternoon.
The wild wasn't meant to be contained. Starting over is the only way.
You've been enjoying the Citadel decks, Matthew? Yeah, we certainly did some real crazy things with those. Why didn't they choose the Nullhide?
Now we're getting started. You fight like a city brat.
Yep. There you go, Trog.
All things begin
perfect.
And end in nature.
That's the card I wanted. Gonna play this now to try to hit land drops, like to be able to play a land drop. I know we can instant speed it, but there we go, rewarded. Another great hand there. Turn two Vivian, turn three Nullhide. Perfect. Hey, Calcutta. Yeah, I like. I still like Soul Tie quite a bit. But I mean, I've had success with all four of those decks. Abzan, Soul Tie, Simic, and Gruul so far here. So it's kind of, I don't know, whichever one you want. I wouldn't mind playing any of them in the ranked ladder, really. But I still think Soul Tie is very, very strong. Question is the Wolfie Boy really good in this deck? It's certainly been fine. We haven't done anything spectacular, but 2/3/3s for 5 mana. Certainly fine. All right, definitely want these. I think Knight of Autumn isn't as valuable in this matchup. I'm going to try one Remorseful Cleric too. That sound right? Doing their Kefnet deck. Yeah, this is like a Kefnet spell heavy deck. They could certainly have Thief of Sanity where Remorseful Cleric can kind of block a Remorseful Cleric, or sorry, can block a Thief of Sanity. I don't, like, they probably have, like, one or two Chemist's Insights. I don't think they have, like, too much stuff where getting the instants out of their yard is really that important. But we'll see. Oh, that's true. I mean, just the whole Terramander card. Getting rid of the instants and sorceries from there. Graveyard for Terramander, of course. Hey, Chief Seth. Oh, it's only turn two, not turn three yet. It's a reasonable card.
Would you like to see what's left of Skull? Strike now! Strike hard!
Yeah, I agree too. I agree with that. I think Ferox is very well positioned right now. Better position than it has been in a while. Because of how much discard there is going on.
Mine less than you.
I agree with that. My plan was here to play Nullhide here until they got that second blue source. And now once they got the second blue source.
Ah! Strike me and you strike nature. Let me show you what was lost.
Because of the risk of Sinister Sabotage, I went with the Jade Light instead. Yeah, so you'd like an Abzan list that has potential?
Ah, I'm a survivor.
check out the Abzan Citadel deck we've played, Calcutta.
Seen puppies whine less than you.
So Oketra, I play that over Nullhide because Oketra just gets. I think earlier I was trying to like save protect Oketra with other creatures, but kind of realized that Oketra is just going to be getting worse. Like without creatures, so starting we might as well just try to play it first. Way. You're welcome, Calcutta. I don't usually see blue-black sweepers too much. I'll play that thing.
Not bad for a mouse.
You can replace Othakaya in that list. Play cast down Mortify instead. Othakaya is just so good against red, in particular. But then, of course, is really good with the Citadel, how it costs zero life to play. All right, 2-1. Keep this going. Our decks perform pretty well. You can see a big difference from whenever we have the Vivians. We're just winning every single game we play a Vivian. Yeah, you just have to upload your list to a site like MTG Goldfish, for example. Just upload it to some website and then paste the link here in chat. All right, turn to Vivian again. Oh, I thought I was playing Sunbelt Grove. Oh well.
I've lost so much already, and the mysteries of life are endless.
That's pretty unlikely to happen. I don't think I've ever seen that. Look at the top three cards, they're just all the same. Hey, Janini.
Things begin and end.
Basically just playing this here to make sure it gets underneath the counterspell. Don't really need to wait instant speed on this one.
Prowess.
Ooh, throwing down the Narset.
I was not prepared for this.
You fight like a city brat.
All right, Calcutta. 24 lands looks really, it looks a little low, not really, but it looks a little low for how high this curve is. And like no Llanowar Elf. It's just a, I guess it's only four fives and 1/6. That's still a lot of those. Yeah, this deck has been definitely playing pretty solid. The question of how hard is it to make the deck, I don't really know how to answer that question, to be honest.
Strike now! Strike hard!
I was certainly hoping that they would use a removal spell to be like 3 mana, or like a counter spell or something, where I'd know that Vivian would be resolving. I really don't want Vivian to get Dovin's Vetoed. I don't think it's worth the risk. I wouldn't play Growth Chamber Guardian in your deck. I would just take all of those out. And get the extra Wild Growth Walker in and another land and a couple other spells. I think having all the Explore stuff and Growth Chamber Guardian is too much of those. I think you do one or the other. Well, the Nullhide's gonna take, like, our opponent knows about the Nullhide. They don't have like the second white yet. It's gonna take like a lot of mana. So if they answer the Nullhide, then the Vivian should resolve. So we went the two clerics, one harpooner, and the Vivian Reed, and took out the Prison Realms. Last time. I think I want this extra harpooner, and I want to cut one of these fives. So I'm going to cut a Tulsimer. I'm going to cut an Oketra, actually. This one puts 6/6 with two bodies. This is like 6/6 with one body. And yes, this makes more 4/4s when we cast more things, but that means then we have to like cast more things after we play it. Which I don't really want to have to cast more things after my 5-drop resolves against Esper. Yeah, Nullhide just is really well positioned in this metagame. People are not really ready for Nullhide. Especially instant speed Nullhide. Attack. Hmm. really do not want Vivian countered. Hey, Zerf, going good. Okay. All right, we get to resolve Vivian. Which is certainly good because we are basically out of things, and we know that all four of the cards in their hand are all threats. And by threats, I mean they're all cards. Like they're not hitting land drops; they just have a bunch of spells over there.
Tear it down. Tear it all down.
Final score of the sub battle on Saturday. I think it was 11-4. That sounds right. There isn't. So sorry, there is not an Ask Todd Discord anymore. It's the subscribers only room. Where does it say Ask Todd Discord still?
You can still walk away.
All right, so I was one man away from this mobilized district. On the information page, okay, maybe it's gone. You're just going by memory. Okay. Yeah, I thought I updated that.
Have you ever lost a home?
So I wanted to get a threat underneath the counter spell, but I don't want to put both of my creatures out because of another Kaya's Wrath. But we got one
I won't hide from the world
to resolve.
Longer. Let's skip to the good part.
For the fallen.
Thanks, three man. So attackers. I've gotten just ties from different spots for like a while. I do a thing called Spreza Box, which sends a new tie and pair of socks and everything each month.
This is hardly my worst defeat.
This specific tie was a gift from somebody else. We have not played the Elf Ramp yet. Yeah, as you can see, this is our first deck of the day, the Selesnya Titans. And this is where our deck's at its best, when we have Vivian.
Wait, you think nature is kind?
I like these mobilized districts in here too. Our mana has not been very bad. We're playing the Angel deck on 4th today. Each of these decks I'll be playing them in a league till so whenever we get 5 wins or 2 losses. And you know, this is the order with Selesnya tokens up, or Titans, sorry, up first. That was a much better showing against Esper this time. We did a lot better job of drawing Vivian. Our opponent did a lot worse job at drawing Liliana.
Tell me your story.
And we're 3-1. All right, not bad, not bad. Yeah, Vivian has been just so impressive in this deck. Like, I honestly wonder if it wants 4 of them. Just makes the deck completely different. Hopefully one day, Matthew. I don't really play best of one, and I don't really play mono red either, so I don't have an answer for you of what kind of mono red deck to play in best of one. Well, even though Paradise Druid's not good against Chain Whirler, if they cast a Chain Whirler here, that means the Steamkin goes away. We'd have to assume that the Steamkin's coming down here. Get Null Hide into play. That thing is very big. Very hard for red to deal with. Chain Whirler was mean. I guess I should have waited on this forest. Now, if we get a shock land, I'll feel kind of bad about that. We just don't have a very good attack with the Null Hide here. For how our opponent was looking at my 2-1 the previous turn, I certainly read that they had a shock, like before they played the Chain Whirler. So playing like a Knight of Autumn and trying to put 2 counters on it wouldn't have really helped that last turn against the shock. So they pay 2 to get rid of the Ferox, then they pay 2 to Lightning Strike the Ferox. Basically take up their turn. If I don't block, I basically never... I don't know how I'm ever dealing with this Chain Whirler, basically. I mean, I guess I need to draw a white source for this Oketra. That's what we need. Well, that went very well for us. About as good as we could hope. Because now the Lightning Strike's out of their hand. Even though we took some damage, we can have the other Knight of Autumn gain some more life. We still really need to draw a white source, another white source for this Oketra. That is not ideal. Steamkin gets that a lot of mana. Play a bunch of spells here. Sala, that's your fault for them drawing the Frenzy. That's your fault. You should feel bad. So you called them drawing another Frenzy off the top. Whenever you call the opponent to draw the best card, that's whenever they do it. See if that's it. Looks like it is. So even though we get to destroy the Frenzy here, we're now at too low of a life total and we don't have other ways to gain life. One 3 damage burn spell and we're dead. Hey, what's up, Fred? Don't let Red win. Ooh, that's gonna be tough. We're gonna be struggling there. We're gonna need them to brick. For a while. That's not bricking.
Hot, aren't I? Let's light it up!
chain roller shot kills us. Let's get these wanderers in here. The Lyra Dawnbringers. All these baffling ends. Cutting Oketra. And we saw there, like, Land War Elves, Paradise Druid. Those are pretty rough against Chain Whirler. But they're kind of necessary to cast spells, especially how we have so many of these expensive spells now. Vivian, I guess I'm going to get rid of one of the 5-mana Vivians. It's still really good. Then I guess I'm going to get rid of Paradise Druid. And one 3-mana Vivian, I suppose. Yeah, we don't have a ton of creatures left for 3-mana Vivian. I could just play some Harpooners instead. Whenever we bring in Baffling Ends and Wanderer, that definitely makes not only 3-mana Vivian, but then also Nullhide Ferox worse. Three mana Vivian giving our creatures vigilance is really nice, though. I want to keep playing this card. I'm getting one Oketra in here. I think Oketra is just really strong. Can't play that. All right, we can play this though. We're gonna be a little bit behind. Like baffling in their 2-drop is a lot better than baffling in their 1-drop. I just want to keep this battlefield clear. Unfortunately, Prism Realm does not get anything like Frenzy. There's a lot of time, and so I'm just throwing out the Baffling End right there, because there's a lot of times like they rely on the one drop to cast Light up the stage. I really wish I didn't put that Oketra on the bottom right about now. If I knew that our next 4 draw steps were going to be 3 lands and a Land of War Elf, we would have kept it, of course. But we land 3 lands at the time, we didn't know that. Wow. Well, to be fair, drawing anything would be good. Yes, drawing Vivians would be good, but drawing anything but lands. I mean, Vivians weren't replacing lands, so all we're doing is drawing lands here. I did put that Oketra down to the bottom when we only had three lands at the time. Which is looking silly now, drawing five lands and a Llanowar Elf in the last six draws. I mean, Vivians weren't going to be in for five lands or a Llanowar Elf. All right, five lands and two Llanowar Elves. I could have kept a Branchwalker. Would have just got me another land also. Well, gave it a try. Probably was going to be chomping with the Llanowar Elf anyway, trading the Mobilized District for a Lightning Strike. Gave it a try. Okay. That's a good one.
Buckle under my blade. I'm old still.
That was a pretty good one.
My wandering continues.
All right, now Lyra, Dawnbringer. Thank you. And Lava Coil, that's unfortunate. I guess we're gonna need Tulsimer now. Alright, never mind, Tulsimer won't do it. Need another Lyra. Dang. All right, 3-2. Not so bad, not so bad. This deck was fun to play. I liked this deck. So I did board out all the Vivians there, that last one. I cut the little Vivian because we didn't have as many creatures in with having Baffling End and the Wanderer in, and kind of went down on Oketra as well. It's kind of tough though. Oketra and Tulsimer and Lyra are all great against mono red there. I kind of feel like Tulsimer may be the worst of them, honestly. I kind of feel like Oketra and Lyra. And, you know, like, this Vivian being able to get us a bunch of creatures and everything. Honestly, I think I should have boarded out Tulsimer's. Watching how the games play out and everything and thinking about it more. Because while this card can gain three life and fight something, it can do that. It doesn't always do that. Because if they just have a Lightning Strike available and they Lightning Strike this Tulsimer with the Enter the Battlefield ability on the stack to put a wolf into play to create a wolf token. If they just do that, then you don't gain three life because Tulsimer's not there, so you won't gain three life and you won't have the fight. So it'll just be like a 3-3 that gets lightning striked and leaves behind a 3-3. And as we saw there with Steamkin and Chain Whirler, 3-3 bodies are not very valuable against mono red. They really aren't. So I think if I would do that again, I'd be cutting the Tulsimer's instead of Oketras and Vivians, and have Oketras and Vivians instead of Tulsimer. Now, we never drew Tulsimer, but that's what I would do for the next time. But it is tough getting... it is tough just getting rid of the Vivians because they are so important. We just saw throughout that whole league that our deck was just miles better whenever we had one of the Vivians in play than when we didn't. That's not really exactly accurate. Not miles better, but... But yeah, this one was pretty sweet. So Wanderer and Lyra are both good against red. They both are. But they also cost 4 and 5. And the problem is against red, our 1s and 2s with Paradise Druid, Llanowar Elf are not very good. Branchwalker doesn't really do a whole lot for us either. We have, like, these Baffling Ends, but I kind of wish we had, like, I don't know what, but, like, more things early against red that were good so that we don't feel as bad keeping in all these Vivians, because then they can take over. I don't, like, have the exact answer for that, but it's just kind of hard to keep in the Vivians whenever we bring in all these expensive cards. But yeah, honestly, I think replacing Tolsimar with Lyra, maybe that's just, like, the 5-mana swap is, like, Tolsimar for Lyra, and then, like, and just keep these two Vivians in. Put in the two Wanderers, take out these two of these Vivians for two Wanderers, and just take out Paradise Druid for Baffling End. Actually, I think that's perfectly fine. I think those are, like, the swaps to do. Yeah, like, I wouldn't mind Shalai's in the sideboard. I think I would probably rather have Shalai than Wanderer, because I think that just having the creatures is really valuable, and Shalai seems like it works really well with all these other things. I think I would rather have Shalai than the Wanderer in the sideboard. It definitely makes you feel less bad about keeping in, like, this Vivian if you have more creatures. Wanderers for the Gruul decks. Okay. Like the mid-range Gruul decks with all the big creatures. I got you. In general. But yeah, this was a fun deck. Selesnya Titan. So again, check out all the information about the deck. Written by Borderland Ranger who made this deck. I have it, if you click on the decklist link, either here in chat or on the YouTube channel, if you go to the description, click on the YouTube or click on the decklist link, you'll find out, you'll see a nice article written about the deck and the specific card choices. So there we go. And it's Wanderers for Is It Drakes also. That makes a lot of sense. Yeah, it's really good against Drakes, for sure. Cool. All right, thank you for watching Selesnya Titans. If you're watching this video later on YouTube, hope you enjoyed it. And I will see you for another video.